Yesterday we learned about the poem The Fly, actually part 1, the first two stanzas. Today we will be dealing with the last stanza and the final part of the same poem The Fly, which was written by Walter de la Mare. Before we move on, let's have a quick look on what we learned last class. In the first two stanzas, we learn how things appear to be in front of a fly. A rosebud, which is comparatively small for us, is like a feather bed for a fly. And thorns, which we may find in rose plants and all, is like spears for a fly. A dewdrop, which is too tiny for us, is like a looking glass or a mirror, and it can see its image in a dewdrop. Golden hair is like golden wire, and mustard seeds, how small it is, right? It's like coals of fire for a fly. So this is what we learned in the first two stanzas. Now let's check it out, what our poet wants to tell us in the last stanza. He says, a loaf of bread, a lofty hill. He says that for a fly, a loaf of bread, even a piece of bread, is like a tall or lofty hill. Then he says, a wasp, which is a small fly now, it is also like a cruel leopard in front of a fly. Then he shows a ball with salt. And when a fly goes near to that, even these specks of salt seems to be very bright as well as big, and which is compared to the lambkins or young sheep for a shepherd. So this is what the poet want to tell us about the thoughts of a fly. Before we wind up, I want to give you some meanings. Let's check it out. Lofty, tall. Speck, very small. Lambkin, a very young lamb. Shepherd, a herder of a sheep, means one who looks after sheep. That's all for now. Thank you. Have a great day.